Welcome to Make a Path Presents. I'm Ronnie Hayes, and today let's talk about the new cover reveal for The Walking Dead issue 185. Now, recently I've been tinkering with the idea of doing the cover reveals at the comic book reviews. Like every month, let's say I'm reviewing issue 184, we will reveal covers 185 at the end of the review and then 186. I've been tinkering with that idea for a while now because obviously there's some people who just hate the covers because there sometimes can be a spoiler in the cover. And I will admit, yeah, sometimes the covers do ruin some things. Like recently, Maggie and Rick's little beef, there was a build up to it, but the cover, there was more anticipation in the cover than there was actually beef in the story, you know what I mean? Anyway, you guys let me know what you think about that idea, but I can still probably, if you want, do mini little 2-3 minute updates saying, hey, here's the cover, and let's kick into another prediction, or a little mini prediction. But I do want to mention this, because I'm seeing a ton of fans talking about, is Carl going to die? Kirkman better not do it. And I don't think that's the direction they're going at all. Not for the comic book. I think killing Carl, forget why they did it on the show. Killing Carl in the comic, especially now, and I'll eat grass if I'm wrong, but it flat out doesn't make any logical sense. In the comic, this isn't a kid who's aging. This isn't a kid who has beef on a set. You know, this is somebody that the artist can continue to draw and draw and draw. As far as I'm concerned, he should be, at this point, the Grimes legacy. If that time comes where they ever want to get rid of, or if the story fits getting rid of Rick Grimes, this is the legacy character, Carl Grimes. And I talked about it before. He doesn't need to be the leader. You can have community members in those leadership roles, and we can follow Carl's story. He doesn't have to be the leader. That's not the case at all. We don't always have to follow leaders as the leads in the story. You can have a lead that isn't the community leader. Anyhow, up to the 185 cover, it says On Guard, and I really do like this cover. Recently, we saw Hilltop being almost finished and very well done and very quickly. They had help from the Kingdom, and they really got to work. I don't necessarily feel like, how do I put this, like there's a villain out there and we'll be getting some type of altercation. I know some people are saying there might be some whispers out there, but it kind of feels like the whispers are dead and gone. They went out with a whimper and they're not coming back. There may be one or two that pop up, but then I'd have to ask, what was the point of killing Beta if we're not going to have any whispers that we can identify or connect with? They'll just be like regular guys, you know, in masks just popping up, and we have no connection to them. Unless they make some really cool-looking whisper, and he was part of the group, but he was leading another section of the group that was in a different area, and they just didn't get back in time, and when they got back, they heard the story about how their people were slaughtered. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. But I think this is just a little part of the story that doesn't, like, putting anything else on the cover would kind of ruin the story, spoil the story, or something that's coming up. And I still think they're going to be bouncing around between the different communities here. And I'll explain why in a second, but let me just show you I think this is November, so this is the second to last, which I'm a little bit shocked. I feel like we're missing a lot of characters. And Negan is going to be, I'm almost positive they confirmed Negan will be this version of the variant for next month, which I'm sorry, the next reveal, which is for December of 2018. This is, let's see, On Guard, November, yes. So this will be the 11th variant cover for the year. Remember, they're only doing these covers for 2018. And the next one should be the last, and it should be Negan, if I am remembering that right. Now, before 185, we're going to be getting this. For some reason, I can't find a bigger image of this, but it is the train that Eugene is going to fix. It says Eugene Tinkers, and this is something I'm actually excited for. And the train will kind of keep the story at a faster pace because now we don't have to wait for our community to take a long-ass carriage ride all the way to the Commonwealth. I was about to call it Oceanside. But now, if they get this train rolling through, it opens up the world even bigger. And that might actually be the next big, you know, villain moment, or the next big conflict, let's call it. because at this time, let's take a look at the cover for issue 183. This is coming up next month. This is the next issue we're going to get as viewers to read or fans to read. It says, "And Michonne without her sword," and it looks like there's a riot at the Commonwealth. So we have the riot popping off at the Commonwealth, and that's going to be the Ezekiel cover. I actually really do like that Ezekiel cover. There's something about that. That looks badass. And then does he look like TV Ezekiel in that a little more than comic Ezekiel? He does, doesn't he? Yeah, he damn sure does. Anyhow, I still love that. It's one of my favorites. So then we got the Commonwealth riots popping off. We got Eugene trying to connect the two communities. And then we got the Hilltop on guard for something. Now, you can make of that what you want and let me know down in that comment box. I still do believe that we shouldn't really be seeing any conflict. If we do, I will be kind of surprised. But I think this is really going to show the community and how they move on after what just happened. Keep in mind, they are rebuilding because they were attacked. And they should have known better. They should have seen it coming. They should have had better army and setup and preparedness. You know, it should have been better. So I think this is going to highlight not what's coming. I could be dead wrong. Watch, I'm dead wrong. Not what threat is coming, but how they have rebuilt and what they're going to be like as a community, as somebody ready for the next conflict that pops off. Like, they're ready now. You know what I mean? I think it's going to highlight that, their preparedness after being sacked and burned to the ground. I think that's all that is. So everyone flipping out about Carl Dine, like I said, he's got to be the legacy character, at least for now. We haven't seen anything that popped up that hints otherwise. So put your thoughts and opinions down below. Do you think this is just the new version of Hilltop that's staying well prepared for the next future conflict? Or do you believe there's a villain, a new villain, or a whisper, or something with the Commonwealth that has them on guard? Put your thoughts and opinions down in the comment box. I'm done talking. It's your turn.